Hello everyone. So yesterday we did a first part of the chapter number 12 of physics, that is electricity. Fine. So I hope you are familiar with the word electricity. I told you what is electricity, what was electric current, what is electric circuit, the SI units of electric current, the formula for the electric current, and what are the instruments that are used to measure the electric current. Fine. So today we are going to the next part of this chapter, but first of all let's have some rapid revision. What was electric circuit? As I told you earlier students, electric circuit is the closed path of a wire conductor, of a wire made up of a conductor through which the electricity passes. It contains elements like wire, switch, a metallic conductor, etc. I also told you that in an electric circuit, the electric current always flows from positive terminals and ends at negative terminal. It always forms the closed loop. It always forms the closed loop. Fine. As I told you, what is current? Anything that flows is known as current. So over here, the electric charge that is flowing is known as electric current. Okay, I hope you are clear with this. Let us go for the electric current. The net electric charge flowing through an area in unit time is known as electric current. I repeat, the net, the total number of electric charge flowing through a cross section area in unit time is known as electric current. We also saw the general formula for the electric current, that was I is equals to Q upon T. Where I is the electric current, Q is the electric charge, and T is the time. Time is always measured in seconds. Remember, time is always measured in seconds. We also saw the SI unit of electric current. As I told you, the electric current was invented by Andrew Murray Ampere, and so the SI unit of electric current is A, that stands for Ampere. The electric charge SI unit is Coulomb, that is denoted by C, and the time, as I told you, it is denoted by S. So you can also write Ampere is equals to Coulomb upon seconds. In our day-to-day life, whatever the electrical appliances we are using is always measured in ampere. Fine. I told you what is the charge of electrons. So one charge, Coulomb charge, is always equal to 6 into 10 raised to 18 electrons. I repeat, one Coulomb charge is always equal to 6 into 10 raised to 18 electrons. That means in one Coulomb of charge, there are almost 6 into 10 raised to 18 electrons which are passing. Okay. Then the question was that what is the value of one electron? I told you the value of electron is always constant. Fine. So one electron is always equal to 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 Coulomb. One electron is equal to 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 Coulomb. I also told you the smaller units of ampere, and there were two types of that. The first one was 1 milliampere. Here 1 milliampere is equal to 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. 1 milliampere is equal to 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. And 1 mu, this is the sign of mu. Fine, so 1 microampere is equal to 10 raised to minus 6 ampere. Here 10 raised to minus 3 stands for 1 upon 1000. And 3 is 10 raised to minus 6 stands for 1 upon 1 lakh. Fine, I hope you are clear with this 1 milliampere and 1 microampere. That is 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. And 1 microampere is equal to 10 raised to minus 6 ampere. Okay. Next thing, an instrument used to measure the values of electric current is known as ammeter. Fine. An instrument measure the electric current is known as ammeter. And the instrument just used to check the presence of electric current is known as galvanometer. It is known as galvanometer. Okay, I gave you the example about the tester. Fine. So this was what we called as electric current and its different types. Today we are going to learn one example so that you can clear out how you can calculate the sums of electric current. And if you are having doubt, please inform me. I will give you more number of examples for calculating the electric current. Okay, let us see over here. In example number 1, they are talking about that the electric current passing through a wire is 0.5 ampere. It is 0.5 ampere. So it is I is equals to 0.5. Remember students, anything the numerical values given in ampere is always electric current. It is always electric current. Okay. So I is equals to 0.5 ampere. Okay. Next thing, time is given over here, that is 10 minutes. Fine. So in an electrical wire, the current is flowing is 0.5 ampere in 10 minutes. You need to calculate the electric charge passing through it. Fine. As I told you, time should be in seconds. Okay, so first of all, we will convert the time into seconds. So that is, if t is equals to 10 minutes, we can write 1 minute is equals to 60 seconds. Then 10 multiplied by 60 seconds is equals to 600 seconds. So this is our time. Fine. What we will do now, we are having an electric current that is 0.5 ampere. This 0.5 ampere, you can write it as 1 upon 2 ampere. Because 0.5 is half, 1 upon 2 is also half. So we can write this 0.5 as 1 upon 2. Okay. So now what happens? I was having a formula, I is equals to Q upon T. What I need to find? I need to find the electric charge. So I need to make the subject of formula as electric charge. I need to make the subject of formula as electric charge. And so the formula becomes Q is equals to I T. Now, I need to substitute the values of this. What was electric current I? 1 upon 2. Multiplied by time, that was 600 seconds. I can cut this 2 with 600 and so I will have 300. Fine. So electric charge is 300 coulomb. Students, this is your final answer. If you are having any doubts or queries, you can please ask me afterwards. Okay. So this is Q is equals to 300 coulomb. Q is equals to 300 coulomb. So these are the types of questions they will be asked you in examination. So be prepared for this type of questions. Fine. So now we are clear with electric current. Okay. But there should be some sort of energy, a force, a work done, which is pulling the electric current or pushing the electric current from one point to another. So there should be some energy. Fine. That can go from one place to another. Suppose we are coming on a scooter or any vehicle from one place to another, there is a petrol or any type of fuel that is pushing our scooter from one place to another. So in the same way, we should have some type of energy in the form of electricity that is pushing the electric current or that is pushing the electrons from one place to another. And the type of energy is known as potential difference. It is known as electric potential or potential difference. Let us see what is potential difference. Usually, potential difference is a charge or a force or a work required to do for getting the electric current from one place to another. Fine. So they are pushing the electric current from one place to another. And that is the energy that is being used over there. Let me read the definition of this. You please note it in your book. The work done to move the unit charge from one point to another is known as potential difference. I repeat, the work done to move the unit charge from one point to another is known as potential difference. So from this you need to be clear that what is potential difference. Okay, the work done to move a unit electric charge from one point to another is known as potential difference. So if electric current was having some general formula, of course the potential difference is also having a general formula. Okay, let us go through this. V is equals to W upon Q. V is equals to W upon Q. Here V is the potential difference, W is the work done, and Q is the electric charge. Okay, so what happens? V is equals to potential difference, W is the work done, and Q is the electric charge. Fine, I hope you are clear with this V, W and Q. Here V is voltage or potential difference, is equals to W, that is work done, and Q is the electric charge. So these are the general formula. Now what about the SI units of potential difference? We also need to know the potential difference of SI unit of potential difference. Sorry, my mistake. So the SI unit of potential difference is voltage. The same thing we were getting from when, that is, it was, potential difference was invented by a scientist named Volta, and so it was named on him, that is voltage, denoted as V. Scientist named Volta, and so it is known as voltage, denoted as V. Okay. Next is work done. What is work done here? The work done is equals to joule. Fine. Work done, new SI unit, joule che. The SI unit of work done is equals to joule. The SI unit of work done is equals to joule. Okay. The next thing is electric charge. As I told you earlier, the SI unit of electric charge is coulomb. So we can also write V is equals to J upon C. V is equals to J upon C, and this is the general formula. You can also write it as V is equals to JC inverse. If any constant term or numerical terms we are having in the denominator, you can get that thing on the denominator with the inverse sign. Inverse stands for reverse. Okay. And so inverted. And so this is V is equals to J upon C, or you can also write V is equals to JC inverse. V is equals to JC inverse. Fine students, I hope you are clear with this. Now as we talk in the electric current, that there is an instrument used to measure the electric current, that was ammeter, also known as ampere meter. There was an instrument used to check the presence of electric current, and that was galvanometer. Similarly, we are also having an instrument that is used to measure the potential difference, and that is known as voltmeter. And that is known as voltmeter. Fine. In today's life, the advanced technology, only one meter is coming which can measure everything. They can also measure the presence of electricity. They can also measure the values of electric current, as well as they can also measure the values of potential difference. And the mixture of this meter is also known as multimeter. And the mixture of this meter is also known as multimeter. Remember one thing, voltmeter is always connected in parallel for the measurement. Fine students, voltmeter is always connected in parallel for the measurement. What is parallel connection? That we will learn it later. But this is for just now. Okay. So students, I hope you are clear with the potential difference, the electric current, the examples of this. Okay. For the better mind, let us solve one more example dependent on potential difference. Okay. So here I have given an example number 2, that the electric charge flowing in a circuit is 2 coulomb. Fine. I have got electric charge. Now what is the values of electric charge? Electric charge is equals to 2 coulomb. Okay. And voltage V is equals to 12 volt. I need to find the work done. Okay. So what is the formula? I hope you are familiar with the formula. That is V is equals to W upon Q. What I need to find? Work done. So that will be W is equals to VQ. Okay, W is equals to VQ. So what happens? W is equals to V. What is V? 12 multiplied by Q. That is what? 2. So it is quite simple. That is 12 to the 24. Don't forget to write the SI units of work done, and that is joule. So the total answer is 24 joule. Now the question is, I hope you are clear with each other, right? W is equal to work done and work done is equal to 24 joule. Okay. Now the question is, from where we are getting this potential energy or the potential difference or electric potential, whatever. Okay, from where we are getting this energy, this potential difference. Have you heard about a word known as battery? Of course, yes. Cell, yes. Used in the remotes and phone batteries, fine. So, cells and batteries are said to be the main source of potential difference through which we are getting some sort of energy. Okay, students. So, potential difference and voltage as the main source is cell and battery. The main source is cell and batteries. What is cell? Let us see. Cell is having a terminal of a positive charge and a negative charge. Thus, this is the symbol of battery having positive charge with a bigger line and smaller line with a negative charge. Okay? So this is the battery. This is the cell. And the combination of cell makes the battery, means like this type. Many types of terminals are there. Positive charge, negative charge, positive charge, negative charge. The similar way, plus and minus, it will be what? A battery. So, the figure will be something like this. Fine, this will be positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. Okay, so this is what we call as battery. This is what we call as battery, and this is what we call as cell. Fine students, I hope you are clear with this potential difference and electric current. This is what I taught you today. One more topic we will clear today, and that is the relationship between the electric current and the potential difference. Okay, let me show you the relation between the potential difference and electric current. You please need to write each and everything in your book so that you can have notes. Fine. And because this topic and this chapter is quite important for the examination, it is also carrying the good weightage for the examination. So you need to write these things in your tech fair book or rough book, whatever you want to write, but please note these things. Okay. So as I told you, we need to study about relationship between voltage and electric current. Okay. So relations between V, that is potential difference, and electric current. And electric current. Fine. And that is known as Ohm's law. That is known as Ohm's law. Okay. So what is Ohm's law? A scientist named George Simon Ohm showed some basic attachment between the potential difference and electric current. And his name was George Simon Ohm, and so it was named as Ohm's law. He showed the direct relation between the potential difference and electric current. Accordingly, he told that potential difference is directly proportional to electric current. Potential difference is directly proportional to electric current. That means this is a sign of proportionality, students. This is potential difference and this is electric current. He told that if potential difference increases, then electric current increases. And if potential difference decreases, electric current also decreases. Both are directly proportional to each other. Fine. And so V was proportional to I. Now in a mathematical solution, there is a proof that we cannot keep this proportional sign over here. And to remove this proportional sign, we need to add some constant. Fine, we need to add some constant. And so to remove this proportionality sign, one constant was added and it was stated as V is equals to Ri or Ir. Here R is proportionality constant. Okay, R is the proportionality constant. Fine. So you can write V is equals to IR. V is equals to IR. You can also write I is equals to V upon R. Or you can also write R is equals to V upon I. So these are the three basic forms of Ohm's law. Okay. So the question is, what is R over here? Here, the word R stands for resistance. Here, the word R stands for resistance. Resistance means what? A disturbance. Resistance means what? A disturbance. Suppose an electric current is flowing, having very high voltage, say 220 voltage, and your fan is working at say 10 to 5 voltage only, then if we pass the continuous 220 voltage, the fan won't be able to bear this much high voltage and it will explode or burn. Fine. So to stop this damage, resistance was invented. So this R is what we call as resistance. Okay. Which resists the flow of electric current is known as resistance. Fine. Can you get my point? R is the resistance. An element which resists means which slows down the flow of electric current is known as resistance. This resistance is not an insulator that will stop the electric current. Actually, this resistance will slow down the resistance. You have seen the speed breakers on the road. The same thing they will work on the electric field. We are going, passing by 60 or 70 kilometers per hour and suddenly a speed breaker comes in between our vehicle. We need to apply the brakes of the vehicle so that we can slow down. And why the speed breakers are made? So that we cannot have an collision, that is accident. The same thing is done in the electric circuit also. So that the flowing of electric current is closed down and so resistance is kept. The symbol of resistance is like this, zigzag. So you can see that if something is coming over here to here, the electricity will slow down and so that there won't be a collision or the burning of wire. It is simple as that. If a bulb is kept over here and a battery is kept over here, we will keep some resistance over here. This resistance is R. This is positive charge, this is negative charge. And if the battery is of high voltage and bulb is of very low voltage, this resistance will resist the flow of electric charge and so this bulb won't get burned. Fine. So electric charge will flow from here to here and then again ends at here. Fine. Are you clear with this thing, students? So this is the resistance, what I told you. So according to the resistance also, resistance is equal to V upon I. From here you can see that R is directly proportional to V, but R is inversely proportional to electric current. That means if resistance is more, voltage is more. If resistance is low, potential difference, that is voltage, is low. But if the resistance is more, electric current is low. And if the resistance is low, electric current will be more. So both are inversely proportional and directly proportional to each other. So this is resistance. Okay, the general formula is R is equal to V upon I. I hope you are clear with the Ohm's law, but still one thing is left, that is the SI unit of resistance. Okay, the SI unit of resistance is what? That R's SI unit is omega. It is omega. I told you V, potential difference is of course V itself, and electric current is ampere, and electric current is ampere, and so R is omega. We can write omega is equals to V upon A, or V A inverse, or V A inverse. Fine. So this is the SI unit of resistance, that is omega, V and I. So we can write omega is equal to V upon A, or V A inverse. V A inverse. So this was, students, the omega, or say the Ohm's law. This is also known as Ohm's law. There were still limitations of the Ohm's law that we are going to study later. But first of all, you should be clear with these things. There are also types of resistance we need to do, and that is, say, the series connection as well as parallel connection that we are going to learn tomorrow. Okay, but this is the basic form of resistance. This is the basic form of resistance. Do you know that where we are using this day-to-day life, this resistance we are using in the fan's regulator. You know the fan's regulator that can change from 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. That is also known as what? Variable resistor. The symbol is this. On a simple resistance, that is this, we need to draw an arrow. That means the regulator of the fan, what we are using, is a variable resistor. It is known as variable resistor. Or also known as rheostat. It is also known as rheostat. Fine. The general name of variable resistor is rheostat. I hope you are clear with this rheostat. Okay. So now what happens? This rheostat, if you will increase the amount of regulator from 2 to 3, the resistance will decrease and the amount of electric current increases. And so the fan speed will increase. Okay, and if you are putting the fan at the regulating 5, that means the resistance is at lowest and the electric current flow is at the highest, and so is fan is flowing at the maximum speed. So the fan is flowing at the maximum speed. But if you are keeping the regulator at 1, that means the resistance is at highest and the flow of current is minimum. Fine. So this was, I know this is quite some dirty, but you need to know and you need to draw this. Find this Ohm's law. This Ohm's law is also known as relation between potential difference and electric current. So you please note this, if in examinations they are asking us that find the relation between potential difference and electric current, that means the same thing they are asking, that is Ohm's law. The general graph of the potential difference was something like this. The general graph of the potential difference was, say this is y-axis and this is x-axis. Okay, this is potential difference and this is electric current. The graph should go like this. It is also known as constant graph. And it is also known as V versus I graph. Okay, so this was the relation between potential difference and electric current that we studied today. We also studied the potential difference, that was the work required to do from one point charge to another, is known as potential difference. The general formula was V is equal to W upon Q, and the SI unit was V is equal to J upon C. The instrument used to measure the potential difference was voltmeter. Fine. I hope you are clear with this. We will continue it from tomorrow. Thank you.